We are back out here at Missouri Wind and Solar in Seymour, Missouri, because Wes is going to educate us on solar systems, because they are always the same, pretty much, whether large or small, right?
Exactly. That's exactly it, Mason. And thanks for coming out.
Yeah.
I know we've shown our solar generator kit before, but we wanted to take just a minute and use this as an example of solar scale.
Okay.
And that's one of the neat things about solar is that regardless of size, you know, this is a unit that's a great camping unit sort of thing. But this is the same configuration if you were wanting to power a battlefield mall.
Okay.
It's strictly about scale. And so that's what we wanted to kind of show people today. And we'll start with the outside.
All right.
And obviously, you know, you've got solar panels. This is just a 100-watt solar panel. And so that's going to provide 100 watts. And so, you know, it's just simple math. How much do you need is how many solar panels.
Okay.
So that's pretty simple. And then on the outside here, and we want to show this from the outside because it's a little bit more challenging when we get into it to take a look at it. On the external right here, we've got the charge controller. And the charge controller does just that. It controls the charge. So what it's doing, thus the name. And so what it's doing is it's looking at the state of your batteries, and it's basically telling the solar panels what to do with its power that's coming in.
Okay.
So are we wanting to put it into the batteries and store it? Are we wanting it to just run across, what we'd say, across the top of the batteries and just be used? And so it's just constantly looking at this. This is a real simple PWM charge controller. It's got some neat features. You can actually plug a USB into it.
All right, so lots of different options for you.
Yeah, and again, this is a real basic unit. You can do a lot more fancy things. Over on this side, you really can't see over here, but then we've got just the outlet. And this is just a standard outlet that you'd pick up at Home Depot, Lowe's.
All right.
And that's where you'd plug into whatever you wanted to use. So the last thing you've got up here, and you can see from the front of it, and then again, this is just a box we picked up at Home Depot. And we drilled some holes in it, and we put a little fan in there just to cool it off. So over here on the back side of this, we just drilled a couple holes. These are just standard connectors. This allows us to easily swap the solar panel in and out and do the connections on them. Keeps a waterproof connection over here. But once we get inside, our solar panels are just run back in here to the charge controller. And that's what we showed on the outside. And then our charge controller connects over into our battery. And this is some of the cool things about this scenario is that the battery size can be whatever you want it to. And if you want to upgrade the battery later, you absolutely could. But it's connected into the battery. And then the battery is connected into our case over here. It's just a small 250-watt inverter. That's what basically converts the battery, the DC charge to AC. And you'll see on this particular inverter, we've just got a standard plug, and that's what comes back over here out to our plugs that we saw a little bit earlier. But that's the basics of a solar system from soup to nuts. And again, if you wanted to power Battlefield Mall, it's all basically the same stuff. It's just more of it and bigger components of it. This is also one of the things that we go over with in our workshop. We use it, again, it's a great example because solar system all in one box.
Yeah,
and,
absolutely.
And also all of our resources from our website, windandsolar.com, links over to our YouTube page. All of this is out there on that and tons of other information about wind and solar.
Right, and I do want to point out for everybody at home, those workshops are great even if you decide that you don't want to move forward with installing everything yourself, right?
Absolutely, that's one of the big things that we talk to people. You mentioned the Homestead Expo. That's one of the big things that we talked with folks out there. It is the cheapest $400 that you'll spend to not do something
if
you came to one of the classes and decided that it wasn't something you wanted to do.
Perfect. Well, Wes, as always, thanks so much for having us out here today, and thanks for all of that great information.
Thanks for coming, Mason.